Here I'm making fried dumplings with gluten-free flour. For the first time, I'm making fried dumplings with gluten-free flour. I've always used, you know, regular unbleached flour, but I realized, I think, you know, gluten bothered me a little bit, you know, with the gluten. So I'm like, okay, let me try and use gluten-free flour. Let me try and go gluten-free. So it's my first time making gluten-free fried dumpling. And let me tell you, so far, I noticed a lot of difference, first and foremost. Kneading this flour, it was almost like Play-Doh. Kneading Play-Doh. And even though I have the stove in low flame, because usually when you make fried dumpling, it has to, you know, you want it to be in low flame so the dumpling could cook from the inside out. You know, you want it to cook properly, you don't want it to burn. So you have it in low flame. But it's been in the hot oil now for a little while, where if I was using regular flour, it will start getting brown already around, you know, the edges, the parts that's sitting in the oil. This one is not getting brown. It's still white. So I'm noticing a huge difference thus far between the regular flour and the gluten-free flour. I wonder what it's going to taste like. So I knead the flour. This is how it looks before I put it in the oil. It's so like smooth. The texture of it is so like perfectly like smooth and soft. It's like Play-Doh, literally. And just the feel of it too. It's not as like sticky, like, you know, stick to your hand like regular flour. It looks and feel like Play-Doh. This is a flour I'm using. I'm using this one for the first time. Christie's, the family tradition, gluten-free, all-purpose flour. Replaces wheat flour. So this is the gluten-free flour I'm using. Making fried dumplings with liver. Ow. Dude, look at the hole is right here, so the steam come up right out of it. If you have a pot cover like this, be careful. Turn it around. Okay, lift it from this side. So I'm making delicious liver. We love liver, and it's really good for you. It's high in iron, which is good for your blood. Here, I made some steam broccoli. And this foil paper right here, this is plantains. I baked it. I baked the sweet plantains. Wrap it up in the foil paper and put it in the oven. And also have baked sweet potatoes to go with the liver and fried dumplings. Yeah, there in the oven is the baked sweet potatoes. I wrap them up in the foil paper. Well, first, before the foil, I wrap it up in parchment paper, and then the foil paper, bake the sweet potatoes. The same thing with the plantains. But guys, look, this fried dumpling is not getting brown in the bottom. Let me flip it and see. Look, it's like really, really light brown. Normally, if this was regular, like I mentioned before, regular flour would already been brown. So when it's all done, I'll let you all know what it tastes like. See, it's hard. little hard. Hear that? Normally I want to make fried dumplings nice and soft. Well, let's see when it's cool. Because, you know, you put a little baking powder in there and a little bit of baking soda, you know, with your little salt and stuff, and it helps it to be like a little, you know, soft and fluffy. But this is my first time cooking with gluten-free flour, because I'm thinking I might have to go gluten-free since I realize gluten bothers me. Just like I can't use dairy, I have to use everything dairy-free. Dairy-free yogurt, dairy-free ice cream, dairy-free milk. So now I have to go gluten-free. So hopefully I like these dumplings. Alrighty. I'll show y'all the finishing look and let y'all know what it tastes like. But it took a while on the oil for it to get to even that brown. Okay, take out the fried dumplings. These are with the gluten-free flour. And always when I have anything fry, I don't usually do a lot of fry stuff. But when we do, we always put paper towel or something to soak up any excess oil. There may be, you know, soak up any excess oil. Oh, that was hot. Ow. I have the fork right here and I touched the hot dumplings with my bare hands. But anyway, this is how it looks, guys. This is with the gluten-free flour fried dumplings. Look a little different from my usual fried dumplings with regular flour. And this is my usual fried dumpling with the regular unbleached all-purpose flour. I made this on our trip to the Jersey Shore. Fried dumplings. These are with the gluten-free flour.
Yeah, this... It doesn't taste good. It doesn't even taste like flour. It tastes like Play-Doh that was fried. It doesn't even taste like something that's like edible and healthy for the human body. If I would rate it out of 5 stars, I'd give it a solid like 0.5.
Oh my gosh, it's that bad, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I tried it. I don't like it that much. Like, ew, why?
Like, I don't even know why I'm giving it a 0.5. I'm just giving it a 0.5 because it's edible. But every single other point is negative. No. Maybe it's the brand. Maybe it's because it's gluten-free, but I'm sorry for anyone with celiac disease out there because you have to eat this.
So there you go, guys. We don't like it that much. It was like, you're still eating it? This was one dumpling. I ate it down to this much. She took a bite of it and she spit it out. So this is a fried dumpling with a gluten-free flour. And I guess we're not a fan of it. I mean, it tastes... I don't even know how it tastes. It's not the greatest. It don't taste like the regular fried dumplings. I guess it's an acquired taste. You probably have to get like used to it. But I guess we're not going to be having this with our liver. With the liver. This is the finishing look of our meal without the fried dumplings. So this is the baked sweet potatoes. And I baked the sweet potato in the skin and I wrapped it up in foil paper, but first the parchment paper, then the foil paper, and bake it the same thing with the plantains. I baked it in the oven in the skin and then I peeled out the skin. That's the liver Guys, it smells so good and it's so tasty with broccoli. Really wanted to have the fried dumplings with it, but here go the fried dumplings with the gluten-free flour. But it doesn't taste like the regular fried dumpling. It's not really that bad. It's just an acquired taste. It don't taste like the regular fried dumplings with the regular unbleached all-purpose flour. So, but this is the finishing look of the complete meal. And not for nothing, these dumplings are hard like rock. Well, they have a little squishy in the middle, but it's really hard. Wait. Dude. Lilia. Oh my gosh. And this is with the gluten-free flour, y'all. Can you imagine I ate one of this? I ate the whole thing. The one I was eating. I finished the whole thing. How you like the dumpling with the gluten-free?
So I'm about to try this gluten-free dumpling. I don't know. Let's see.
But it seemed a little soft. You know what? Because it'll warm it up a little bit.
Well, I don't know. Mixed feelings. I'm so a little doughy. No, it's healthy.
It's like Play-Doh. Like Play-Doh.
Yeah.
You like it?
A weird aftertaste.
It has an acquired taste.
I mean, if you get used to it, you know, it doesn't have gluten, so it's, you know, for all the people who are allergic to that. And
like Nelia said, for all people with the celiac disease and stuff, that doesn't have gluten.
Doesn't make you bloated. Not even dumpling. I mean, you get used to it, it's fine. Because you used to regular flour, so I could adapt to it. What do you think?
I don't know. Let me try it again.
No. I'm getting used to it already.
It's an acquired taste. So yeah. There you go, guys. Dumpling with gluten-free flour. Mm-hmm. And if you ever use gluten-free flour, drop in the comments below. Let us know what you think about it. Okay? And like different recipes that you may make with gluten-free flour. Mm-hmm. Okay? So bye, guys. And don't forget to like, share.
And subscribe.
Okay. Bye. Yeah.